Thank you. habits on branches and a bicycle wheel. Viv Corrigan on voice and effects, and Lawrence Cassidy on.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Every chaos poem was a perfect poem. I'm not talking about a perfect mess. I'm talking about perfect chaos. So, when is something perfect? This is an easy question to answer. And something is perfect if every tail is perfect. For example, in the end of the 19th century, there was a guy called Stéphane Mallarmé. He wrote a poem, it's called Un coup de déné. So, how can I translate that? Can you translate Un coup de déné? Maggie, do you know how to translate it into English?
Is it something like that?
Yes, it's... what is this? Yeah, it's a cube, yeah. Yeah, you. Yeah, this was kind of a perfect poem. And in America, famous author, she's called Sylvia Plath, that wrote a book almost with perfect poems. So almost each poem in this book was perfect. So that's about the theory in literature. But then people came and say, oh, it's also, the picture can be perfect. This is a picture from Japan. You know this one? All of you, I hope you got part of this poem, of this picture. It's from 1832. It's called Shima Agawa on the Tokaido. And here, you see the Fuji. It's a perfect mountain. But each part of this picture is perfect. So if you want to build a chaos poem, you can use all the elements of the poetry you know and regrew up. And in Germany, it's a little bit like we could not, in my age, we could not understand English, but we loved it. And we translated it the way we liked it. And often every word became magic. You know, my independence seems to vanish in a haze. Perfect. This is really poetry. And I think every one of you has poetry from songs, from literature, from symbols, maybe symbols. So I have a friend who is in love with traffic lights and traffic signs. He especially loves the stop sign. You know, it's a specific shape, and there's a big white stone in red color. He loves this. This is a poem for him. So, how to build a chaos poem? So my wife, she specialized in chaos poems. And she's also specialized in ready-mades, so maybe you haven't realized there's some ready-mades of my wife and me in the windows. This is Crocodile Shark, this is Nemo's Vision, and this is on the side you have the empty room and outer space. So if you haven't watched it, enjoy. And now it's your turn. So, there's one thing which should motivate you. Normally such a long concept. concert will end with a tutti. It says that all the musicians play together very carefully, trying to motivate you while you're building a chaos poem. And for this chaos poem, I give you stickers. So it looks like a white sheet of paper, but the trick is, Jacob organized so much, and he also organized this paper with his fingernails like me, or maybe from the other side. I only want to make it once for you, show it to you. That's another way to do this. So, it sticks. So, while all the musicians are playing, I come around and give you these sticker papers. And I give you pens. And you can write. You can choose a color you like. You can choose different colors. You can make, you can write rainbow poems with these pens and pencils. These are the pencils, enough for everyone. And I give you also, again, a few of these puzzles here. And I have a few sticks. You see, there are only three today of this kind. They are wooden. And here's a lovely supermarket across the street, and you can build your own sticks. So I tried it before. So you can do it like this. You know, it's not very stable, but if you put it like this, circle it around. For demonstration, I do it very fast. So, but if you do it very slow, then. So, you look, it's stable now. And now I built my first chaos poem today. I close my eyes and I'm trying to find the Fuji. No, it's not. It doesn't matter. Maybe Yoko is Fuji. And then I have a sticker. You see? I stick the puzzle. Building these kinds of states and share it to each other. So you exchange it while the music is playing. Then it becomes a chaos poem. It's nothing individual then. It's something about sharing, and it has the quality of your personal impact on these states. And at the end, you're invited to go outside and you can show it. But it's not to someone in the street, for example, but it's not a demonstration. It's more to something very shy. You say, okay, this is my favorite chaos poem. So it's in the past. You can say, oh, I'm going to say something about that. I think you have 5 to 10 minutes to build your chaos poem. Then you are invited to stand up, walk, move with musicians, go out. thinking of this beautiful thing, thinking of everything you enjoy today, and I bring you all the elements you need to build the chaos poems. Any questions? Yes, you can. What you can do? So this was a tricky question. So all the most tricky things are a little bit like. Which words? How many? Oh, depends on you. For example, I only took a small sheet of paper, but you can. If you like the whole sheet of paper, then you're okay. What then you mean? To try to take the paper out of the box. It's all
Thank you. Nice to have two pianists on today. Nice piano. So we have now a trio, some of whom, in fact everyone kind of might play later in some different combinations in the third set, which should be longer. But second set will be Yoko Miura on piano. Jim Corrigan on voice. And Lawrence Kessley on electronics.
Thank you. I'm happy that you can perform our second improvised opera with the mopomoso TV orchestra, with many guests and friends. And I have to say a few things to prepare this event. It does not work any very long, and it's the last item of the show. Maybe it's only 5 minutes, maybe it's 50 minutes. You decide how long it will take, because everyone in the room is invited.
We've got an hour and a half, basically.
Yes, but sometimes we are in a cage here in this room. And the most important part of the program will happen outside. You will leave the room, we will leave the room. And those who want to stay, I don't know what to say. The background story of this is last year we did opera, an improvised opera, and people said, oh, this is not true. It is not possible to improvise an opera. But we did it. And my wife said, okay, there are people that don't believe in improvised operas. How can we convince them that it is reality? And she said, use chaos poems. as a basis of an opera. And then she found out, or not she, but one of her friends, she's called Patricia Christie, that Luton in the north of London is one of the center of improvised or chaotic poets. So it happened yesterday. It was very successful. It was very easy, and I have some of the results for you in the big city to get familiar with it. I'm not sure if everybody here in this room has ever built a chaos poem.
No.
Okay, so it's very easy. I'll show you. This is a chaos poem built yesterday. This is another one. So, Tim, I give it to you.
Thank you.
You have no
chaos poem.
But the thing is that you build your own chaos poems. So I have to do this.
So
this is for you. Alan, this is for you.
So I have a few more, if you would like to see them. You can get this, but the most important thing is you have time now for creating your chaos poem.
Yeah.
And that's the reason why Jacob organized these papers. So, Tim, you need to pay for it. And just got this possibility. You have paper. So I leave it here. Everybody can use a paper. Ah, the background guy saying papers. It's all papers for you. And yesterday we went into a church. And in this church we have a lot of pencils. And today it's restricted to 4 cans. But I was told that in London, England, it's not a problem. So I give you a pen,
okay.
And you can swap pens. You know, you can exchange these pens.
4 pens.
So you like that pen? Or Helen, you need 2 pens.
You always need 2 pens.
Yeah, yeah. Don't steal it. Give it away after the show. There, where you can buy the drinks. And then I have puzzles for you. Because the elements of a chaos poem are not only words. They can be pictures. They can be part of pictures. And there's one thing I did not mention yesterday, because the people of Luton know this. So this is the most dramatic announcement today. Some people think it cannot be dangerous to write a poem. Is anybody in the room who thinks it's not dangerous? Okay. For you, you have to read this book. That's by Mikhail Bulgakov. He's Russian. He was Russian. And the book is called Past and Margarita. It's about a poem on Jesus. So yesterday we were talking about poems on Jesus, but be careful if you want to write or make a chaos poem on Jesus. So don't do that, not before reading this book, okay? And puzzles you got from these pictures. They're related to Bulgakov and another author from Japan, maybe Yoko knows him. He's called Murakami, and he did a novel called Killing Commander Taube. Killing Commander Taube is a novel on a picture, and this was inspired, maybe inspired by this picture by Oxide. You see the fish Pucci on that? And those who find Pucci in the back can be very happy. This part of the puzzle, of course, is element of the possible chaos poem. Because chaos poem, the chaos poem, I was told by a fox surfer who's called Christoph Brut. He said, every chaos poem is perfect. And the other way around doesn't work. So you invited just you. There's one important thing you have to know. This is magic paper that Jacob organized because
Christopher, we demonstrate here. I've already written one.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Let's figure it out.
Yeah, so it sticks. Yeah. And you can. You need things like this. They're very colorful, they're from Luton. And if you have one, it's not very stable. But if you put two together, I'll demonstrate. And this is the last minute of the demonstration. Then, take this. You take your pen, write your poem. It could be something like, you know, the name of the person you love. It could be a part of the poster. It could be a part from something. Or it can be a puzzle like this. So, this is not Gucci one. So, I put it here. I stick it here. So, it's a nice chaos poem. But this is half of the truth. If you believe in chaos poems, you have to show it to someone else. It's a little bit like a love letter. And of course, if we are in one room, then people believe, maybe think, maybe it's not for me. Maybe it's for someone else. Or so you don't own this chaos poem. So you can exchange it with your partners. You can add things to that, and then you can leave outside and show it wherever we want. But it's not a demonstration because there's nothing we are fighting for. It's just we are believing in arts, poetry, and things like that. Any questions? Okay, yeah. So in Luton, it was a problem to be explained because the Luton people, they are really the. Yeah, it's a good question.
Can I write about the yellow balloon I still have from the opera?
Yes, you can. Yeah. It's like last year, you're allowed to do a lot of things, normally you're not allowed to do. And now, for preparation, there's another element for an opera. It's a rehearsal part. And normally we have mopomoso and classical conventional way. But John Russell used to do another concept which is called the quaqua. And what we are going to do today is a quaqua express. So have you ever joined the Quaqua Express? The Quaqua Express is goes like really fast going on. So it's not like there's a group and playing 15 minutes or something like that. The groups are playing not very long, but very intense. And every group is a little bit different and it will be getting spontaneous on stage. And my job today, as a master of ceremony, I should invite the musicians on stage. And before the opera, which when you build your chaos poems, then the musicians will keep on playing after the solo of Pascal. He'll play a very nice solo, I know. And then you know, okay, when Pascal is starting, then, yeah, in the next few minutes, we're starting. So we go outside, maybe you come back, things like that. And before that, we have the Quagmire Express, starting with Floridana Fifi and Steve Beresford. Okay.
Thank you. Thank you. Luton. Yeah, Luton. Yeah, Luton. Luton. Has a point.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Some fun tonight, Dave.